From electric to hybrid vehicles, the way we travel sure is changing, huh? But perhaps the greatest change is automation, taking control away from humans, handing it right over to technology.
Humans that are often distracted. Now, it may sound like a far-off concept, but as I found out, it's already here in some various different ways on our roads, and it could be playing a bigger role in our lives. And the governor, he's right there in the passenger seat, too. It's a story that's new at 9.
Do you almost feel like this is a safer way for you to drive and get yourself about town?
I do. I definitely do. See how it just hesitated right there when that car jumped in front of us barely? You know, if someone wasn't paying attention, they could have, if that car cut over, they could have hit it. It's amazing. It's constantly watching what we're up to.
Rick Nakashima owns one of about 1,000 vehicles on Hawaii's roads that are semi-autonomous, meaning they perform some levels of self-driving abilities using upwards of 24 sensors that can see and recognize much more than we ever could.
Okay, now if we want to change lanes, just turn the blinker on. Not doing a thing there. Gets one lane over.
According to the head of the Hawaiian Auto Dealers Association, or HADA, the technology, while impressive, is still relatively in the early stages, and the number of self-driving cars here will grow as fast as the technology itself.
Well, driverless cars will be here in 2020, they say, and of course there's 5 different kinds of them, 5 different levels. There's hands-on, hands-off, eyes-off, mind-off, and then no wheel.
For now, not only do all the semi-autonomous cars still have steering wheels, they have built-in sensors that require the driver to, at the very least, maintain a physical connection, even when in autopilot mode.
The technology is already here, but is the state ready, and are we ready for a car that completely drives itself?
Turns out, when it comes to these self-driving cars, Hawaii is, in many ways, ahead of the curve. In fact, Governor David Ige recently traveled to Google headquarters in California to see firsthand what these cars in the future have to offer.
I think the real focus by everyone that we talk to is they truly believe that autonomous vehicles can reduce significantly the traffic deaths that occur on our highways because these cars can be safer.
Arizona was among the first states to embrace Google's futuristic car, and just last week, they started allowing residents there to sign up for rides in an effort to educate and gain valuable feedback. Governor Ige says Hawaii is perfect when it comes to hosting and advancing the same technology.
I do believe that Hawaii can be a good test bed for these vehicles. Obviously, we're self-contained and we don't have to worry about a car traversing a state boundary. You know, we can control the environment.
Mindful of the fact these cars are not perfect and have been involved in accidents, Governor Ige believes by creating scenarios and test situations, Hawaii can play a key role when it comes to improving their safety and ultimately our safety. Something else the governor thinks that these cars could improve? Our economy.
Part of the conversation was to allow us to hopefully maybe attract research and development types of jobs in addition to serving as a test bed. But more importantly, on a long-term basis, I really am looking to see if we can establish research and development facilities here in Hawaii, which would create quality jobs for our community.
It's a whole new way of driving, isn't it?
It's amazing, especially in stop-and-go traffic. It just makes stop-and-go traffic like nothing.
In addition to adding more jobs, there's also a shared belief that these cars could one day help eliminate our worsening traffic.
Well, driverless cars can move a lot of people. They say eventually it'll be like a school of fish going down the roadways because they can stay so close to each other. I flew jets many years ago, and we flew formation, of course, with just a foot and a half overlap. So the cars can do that when they're in the driverless mode.
Well, that may be a decade or more away. The reality of today is you may very well be driving next to a car that's driving itself.
Right now, with a driverless car, it's sort of like a guardian angel on you. In other words, the car doesn't text, and the car doesn't have a root beer float on the right seat. So it actually is safer in these driverless modes. And so insurance rates go down, accidents rates go down, deaths on the highways go down.
Okay, great stuff. But while self-driving cars may not get distracted like us humans do, they're not perfect, and there are some areas where the cars still need to improve. Now, among those, potholes, even with the car's many sensors, these can sometimes be missed. Of course, other drivers. All the sensors in the world can't keep another car from ramming into you. And then there's the issue of making a so-called ethical choice. Say a child runs into the road, there's a pole to the left, a wall to the right. Humans would make a real-life choice, but what would the car do? That's something engineers are still working on through image identification and other means.